Exlabs, founded in 2023, is driven by a bold vision to shape the future of deep space infrastructure, pushing humanity beyond geosynchronous orbit. Their mission is to unlock the vast potential of deep space by developing scalable, affordable solutions tailored for geosynchronous orbit and beyond, referred to as GEO+, to power deep space exploration, resource acquisition, and planetary defense. With a team composed of veterans from leading commercial space companies and space agency missions, Exlabs is well equipped to lead this charge. The company is focused on moving past low Earth orbit with modular spacecraft designed for extended missions. These vehicles are built with nuclear-ready capabilities, making them ideal for the demands of deep space. If you are imagining these spacecraft mining asteroids, you're spot on. Exlabs has a keen interest in harvesting space resources, though we'll explore that topic later in the video. Beyond their own missions, Exlabs deep space vehicles support rideshare opportunities through their Mission as a Service program. Much like SpaceX's transporter missions, this initiative allows smaller satellites or vehicles to hitch a ride into deep space, broadening access to these distant regions. They have an ambitious roadmap which we'll explore further in this video. But first, let's talk about an exciting mission they have planned that supports deep space exploration, space resources, and planetary defense in a single mission. ApophisExL Mission. This mission will visit the infamous Apophis asteroid in 2028. I call it infamous because at one point, there were fears it could hit our planet or come extremely close. Given its 375 meters, that's 1,230 feet in length, that would be a very bad day for Earth. Luckily, the latest observations showing the closest approach on the 13th of April, 2029, will be at a distance of 32,000 kilometers. That's inside the orbit of geostationary satellites. It should be visible to the naked eye in some regions. Research now confirms no impact risk for at least the next century, ruling out threats in 2029 and 2036. NASA plans to fly by with their OSIRIS Apex, known previously as OSIRIS-REx spacecraft. ESA is also looking into flying a spacecraft near the asteroid in time for the 2029 visit. Exlabs is getting in on the action with their ApophisExL spacecraft, providing the world's first deep space rideshare mission. The mission launches in 2028 and will fly by the asteroid before its closest approach to Earth. The mission should provide critical data for planetary defense and science. The company says this mission demonstrates their commitment to enabling sustainable, high-frequency access to deep space. SERV, Science Exploration and Resources Vehicle. The Science Exploration and Resources Vehicle is Exlabs' flagship spacecraft, a modular, stackable, and fully autonomous platform designed for missions to geosynchronous orbit and beyond. Built for rapid deployment, SERV stands out as the first nuclear-ready commercial spacecraft. Its flexible design allows it to adapt to customer-specific missions without requiring architectural changes, offering solutions like hosted mission services and customizable hardware platforms. With a payload capacity exceeding 5,000 kilos, that's over 11,000 pounds, and a maximum delta V of 7 kilometers per second from low Earth orbit, SERV is equipped for deep space exploration. A table of possible destinations shows its reach, highlighting its potential for long-duration missions. Exlabs is eager to collaborate with startups, research institutions, and space agencies seeking deep space opportunities. Through payload hosting and rideshare options, partners can join SERV on its primary mission, similar to how Astroforge hitched a ride with the IM-2 for its asteroid mining mission to the Moon. A key partnership for Exlabs is the company Antares, a space startup regular viewers of my channel will be familiar with. Antares are developing nuclear microreactors for lunar and Martian surface use, capable of providing 40 kilowatts of constant power with no servicing. Exlabs plans to integrate this microreactor technology into SERV, providing a huge amount of power for propulsion, onboard payloads, and scientific equipment. As Exlabs notes, nuclear power is essential for extended long-duration missions. Unlike solar panels, which provide less power the further the spacecraft goes from the sun, nuclear energy delivers consistent, high power for larger propulsion systems and big payloads. Together, Exlabs and Antares aim to launch a SERV vehicle equipped with a nuclear microreactor in late 2028 or 2029 as a demonstration. It's not clear what type of nuclear propulsion is planned. We can speculate though. The most plausible method for propulsion using Antares nuclear technology is nuclear electric propulsion. This method uses a nuclear reactor to generate electricity that is then used to power ion thrusters or other similar electrically powered thrusters. This is more efficient than the alternative nuclear thermal propulsion, but has lower thrust. It's ideal for non-crewed deep space missions. A successful demonstration could pave the way for widespread adoption of nuclear-powered spacecraft, unlocking new possibilities for missions beyond GEO and solidifying SERV's role in the future of deep space exploration. ACQR, Autonomous Capture and Acquisition Robot. This robot, under development by Exlabs, will be able to autonomously capture space objects. The company has received a grant from SpaceWorks of $1.9 million to work on this technology. The funding will enable Exlabs to move beyond the design phase, building and testing a prototype of the ACQR. This robot can be combined with their surface vehicle, offering a solution for navigating to and securing large objects in space. Future updates of SERV can handle payloads of up to 30 tons, making this combination a powerful tool for space operations. Upcoming events. One mission has already been announced, the Apophis mission in 2028. We know Exlabs are working on a second mission, which will be announced soon, according to their website. Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. In the coming weeks, I'll be launching a live stream to recap the videos I posted, answer your questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Stay tuned for details. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.